After that, mitochondria, our next cell organelle is plastids. Plastids is a cell organelle which is only present inside the plant cell. Only in the plant cell plastids are found. Plastids are mainly of two types. That is, first is chromoplast and second is leucoplast. Leucoplast type of a plastid, it's colored type of plastid which show some type of colors on the plant cells, their leaf and the different type of thing, everything, like we see flower, leaves have a green color, or this color is due to the plastids. That is the chromoplast plastid which show some colors. Second is leucoplast. Leucoplasts are the type of plastid which are usually white or a colorless type of a plastid. Next is chromoplast. Chromoplast consists of some chlorophyll. Chlorophylls are the pigment which is present inside the leaf part of the plant, leaf part consists of a chromoplast. Chromoplast consists of this pigment which is chlorophyll, and chlorophyll gives the green color to the leaf. We see green color of the leaf. Why the leaves are green? Because of the chlorophyll that present inside the chromoplast of the leaves. Second is leucoplast. What is the function of leucoplast? Leucoplast mainly stores the type of oils, proteins, starch. So they store them and they help the they help this organelle to use them after when required. They store this type of oil, proteins and the ribosomes and other things, which sugar, starch, that is made inside the plant. They store them and then they help the plant cells to when they required it, they release this. After this, the plastids also have its own DNA, ribosomes. Plastids also consist of genetic material, that is DNA, and ribosomes, which is protein. They synthesize them and they store them, and they have their own type of DNA and ribosomes. After then, plastids, next is vacuoles. Vacuoles are the empty areas, empty place where the storage sacs, this is also known as storage sacs. Store sacs, what does they do? They mainly in them plants vacuoles. Vacuoles are the storage sac. Sac means the empty area, empty space, empty area where something can be stored. In vacuoles store something. Vacuoles are found in both animals and plant, but in animals vacuoles are found in a small size as comparison to the plants. Plants consist of larger size of vacuoles. What does they do? They provide turgidity and rigidity. Turgidity and the rigidity are the type of a pressure which they provide the shape and the space and the definite shape to the cell, and help them to transfer thing from inner area to the outer area, and they create some type of pressure so that cell can maintain the outer pressure and the inner pressure area, so that they can easily, this is a rough type of structure, and they help the cell to transfer things from outer to the inner surface. Other than this, vacuoles also store types of sugar, amino acid, protein. They store this material so that they can which help further to the plants, so that when required this type of proteins, acids, so for the functioning of the cells, then they use this type of this storage sugar, amino acid and the proteins. So the vacuoles store them for the later use, and vacuoles also helps in the processing, like different type of process which body does, like respiration, cleaning waste, taking nutrition. All this type of functions, when they take place, vacuoles help them to do more, they work properly and provide them required materials like the sugar, amino acid, protein and other things, so that they other organelles, their other functions, life processing, person, like nutrition, respiration, can easily perform without any error, without any problem. With the vacuoles, we learned about different type of cell organelles. By this, it is completed. Cell organelles are completed here. After cell organelles, we are going to study about the cell division. There are mainly two type of cell division. First, we are going to study about what is cell division. The process in which new cell is formed is known as cell division. It can be formation of cell can be done by the parent cell, in which a parent cell divide into two, or from the other cell. New cell is developed. This type, mainly cell division, consists of two type, that is mitosis and meiosis. This mitosis and meiosis is the type of cell division in which cell mainly divide by the different processes. First is mitosis. Mitosis mainly consists of a mother cell, a main part of cell which further get divided into two identical daughter cells. This is the mother cell and these are the daughter cells. This cell get divided, they separate, they divided into two parts, equal two parts. This contain same number of chromosome. If it contains four chromosome, then the daughter cells, each daughter cell consists of four chromosomes also. The number of chromosome will be same in both the daughter cells. It divides itself into two daughter cells. What happened in meiosis? Meiosis consists of a two type of consecutive division in which first a main parent cell divided into two, then this two consecutive division divided into other, each of them divided into two parts. So at the end they forms four type of four cells. In this chromosome consists of mother cell consists of four chromosome, then the other chromosome divide consists of two chromosome, and the after them the next will consist of one chromosome. So in this mother cell slowly by division by divided two times converted into one to four daughter cells, four new cells. They form four new cells. In this number of chromosome get decreases by the division. So these are the processing. These are the main process of cell division. Two type of cell division: mitosis and meiosis. By this our chapter has been completed. Your work is to write all this thing in your notebook. You can maintain a notes over this organelles and the cell division and the every part we have studied in this chapter about cell. What are the cell, what are the function of the cell, what are the cell organelles, which cell organelle is known by which name, what are the other name of cell organelles. We have already learned all this in this chapter. Now your work is to complete, write down all this thing in your notebook with in a proper manner, in a fair manner, in a